Carol, come on.
That's a machine.
So let's, how about you just play a little bit, see what comes. All right, I think it's ready to go. So you're gonna play, she's playing the Tartini concertino. All right. That's fine, that's good. That's a good plan. Okay, great. Okay, now let's try it one more time. And remember, I always say the open G can tell us a lot about our embouchure and the sound, okay? So if you're, again, if you're here, so let's try that one. So I want to see if we can find the proper position, and I want you to memorize which one feels the best and which one you think gives you the most resonance, okay? So let's start really, just really at the tip of your ear. Let's take a little more. You didn't like the last one, and you didn't like the first one. So, which was your favorite?
The second one.
Yeah, I think so. So, did you all agree? It had the most resonance, and it seemed like she was comfortable, yet it was really projecting out there. Okay, and remember, the other thing that we always talk about is the angle of your instrument. So, if my head is like this, similar to what we were talking to the first young lady, my pitch is off, and I'm not getting a really good grip on my instrument. So, I'm going to bring my instrument to me. See, so that's a soft dynamic play. It has to be that loud. Okay. You know, this is loud. Okay, now you see if you can project it just a little better. Good. All right, let's think also. Can you see that now? Better. You felt better about that too, didn't you? because, again, it's all about your sound and really blowing through the technical passages. But so often we hear, you know, when you're going over your registers, it's a little difficult. So can you just try the beginning? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. We don't have much more time, but I just want to show you how to practice it a little bit. Bring it. What happened to our good sound? Bring it back.
Thank you. that again. So there's a few notes inside there. That's the idea. And then, not just to play the interval, but to prepare the interval with the air. Air equals sound. If we don't use enough air, we will not receive enough sound. So think about always going in to the upper note as we're ascending, or if you want dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da, if your constant note is a tempo, going into the bottom note. And I think making up several exercises like that, without even looking at the page, kind of wandering around on the outside. Actually, I used to do this when I watched the sports on TV. Okay, I'll turn the sound down, and I would just practice that. Now, I don't advise you to watch TV while you practice. Mom's like, I bought you that clarinet, now you're watching, you know, soap operas while you're practicing your clarinet. No, but to try to get it to become automatic by concentrating on other things, but thinking about the air direction. So that's the first thing. And I'll be very quick on the other. What was that? Yes. Can you play a few minutes? I feel that that long tube note didn't have the same kind of air support as the shorter tube note. It's a more resistant note, isn't it? Right? So keep that air in mind. Try one more time. And think about directing the air. Sometimes that the air stops here. And in our air should we have to direct this at various points out in front of us. Not just up and down, but three dimensional. So if I'm going